I sailed from Seattle, far away from friends and home, across the blue Pacific to the land of morning calm. Here's a helmet and a rifle and your prophylactics too. And as sure as I'm your captain, we will make a man of you. The 105s were pounding and their thunder shook the night. I asked my bold commander, who am I here to fight? It's the slopes and the slants, it's the gooks and chinks, said he. And I wondered if their captain ever said the same of me. I'd seen the mountain winter, where the air is cold and still. But oh, that frozen Chosun, it was a living hell. With the fever and the jaundice and 100 kinds of mold, we were slaughtered in our mummy bags by bayonets and cold. And everywhere I travelled, from the Gap at Coomaree, the Yongsan Reservation to the camps at Moonsunnee, from the golden plains of Incheon, my boots rotting on my feet, all I heard were crying babies while their mothers walked the street. We bought watches, we bought cameras, we bought whores and we bought booze, with the little barefoot beggars bending down to shine our shoes. We gave them back our candy and to answer our desire, oh, we gave them round-eyed babies who died outside the wire. I got off in Seattle and I climbed on board a train. I rode it through the mountains with a fever in my brain. I could find no reason to remain here anymore. Oh, there was no sign around me of the life I'd lived before. Then what's the pride in country if it robs a man of will? What's the pride in manhood if a man will rape and kill? And what's the pride in killing if the dead will rise again? Ah, but there's a pride in knowing that the enemy's within. So listen, all you troopers, here's a lesson you should know from an older brown shoe soldier who marched off long ago. They will use your pride and passion for to settle all their fights. Keep your pride in your trousers and your captain in your sight.